We'll see how things do shape up here for Secret and for Fantastic Five. Remember, there is a lot at stake for Fantastic Five as well as Secret. If you'd like to get into the TI main event, if you're Secret here, you win the game and you're good to go. So we'll see how things shape up for now. So far, Pilot Eye already rotating in towards that mid lane, looking to drop a ward down. That won't be contested. Might get de-warded, probably not. Puppy TP, and I think trying to get the ward down, but it looks like Yol did the same, making sure Puppy couldn't get that ward in that aggressive dual lane off lane. And
I mean, if there's one thing you're trying to study your opponents between games, Fantastic Five had a break before this game. As like a support player, you watch where do they TP at level one? Where are their preferred warding spots? Like your captain, your drafters maybe looking at their drafts and rotations a bit, but if you're just like the support player, you want to know where you want to TP at level one. So that's a good. He obviously read some of those secret replays and kind of figured out where to go.
They will, I think, see this ward placed down. Secret had that ward over towards the Actually, I don't know if they saw that rotation. Where's that ward placed? Oh, they should have seen the rotation up towards that top river spot. They should know that ward was placed down, and so Secret should have a counter ready to go. They have the axe as well as Pilot Eye with the sentry. But Pasha, he's been scouted out. Pilot Eye and RTZ walking up to the high ground, being pretty aggressive here, but they just really want to secure this top rune spot, making sure that there's nothing happening with the Night Stalker. Meanwhile, down bottom, it'll be BZZ grabbing it for the Timbersaw, so Secret's not getting both of the wards this time, and then Puppy drops the sentry as well to, I believe, block the camp, although my alt button isn't working. I believe this blocks it.
Yeah.
I think this camp, probably.
Yeah, it's a pretty big circle. Orange, the Night Stalker, pinged it out, so it looks like he knows that was planted there and needs some sentry help, but
no Iron Town, by the way. He'll get it eventually,
okay.
I imagine, but
yeah.
If he's having a rough lane at one point, I'm sure he will go to the jungle.
He's probably expecting Puppy to spend more time bottom, because going back to last game, it was a Axe, Darkseid, dual lane bottom, but completely different from Secret. Darkseid's jungle, Axe's jungle, Secret's going full greed mode here. Bulba with the Iron Talon. This is a complete change up from Secret. I think they see this Morphling and they're like, we can out-greed these guys.
Rolling boulder, Pilot Eye, Puppy's up there. He doesn't have call, counter helix. He went for it at level 1 just so he can jungle. Yol will take some right clicks and Thunder Strike. Shouldn't die here, I don't think, but he'll take a lot of damage. He has no salve, but tankos aplenty. And Yol will be able to get up towards the enemy jungle, back towards mid. He's going to tango up real quick, and they have another hero coming in. It was Bulba, but he doesn't have vacuum yet. They could search Puppy up, but Yol will just rolling boulder away. That was a long chase. I think Puppy just wasting a lot of time just trying to zone him out there.
Yeah, Puppy wants to keep tabs of the Earth Spirit because it protects all your lane if you know where he is, and he can't be aggressive if Axe is kind of keeping vision of him. So that's why in the end he's like, I got a rolling boulder away, because you've got to break that line of sight before you can get active on the map again.
Now he's gonna, he was thinking about heading back top lane, but unfortunately he's kind of stuck in no man's land. If he goes to mid, there's a ward that will scout him out. This is like one of the most common spots. If you're sitting top, you rotate mid as an Earth Spirit, it's gonna be scouted out easily by that ward, so finding a kill there will be harder. But I do like this from Yol, and this is something you'll see often with Earth Spirits and Elder Titans, is you just leech the jungler's experience, maybe try to get some CS, and actually just be aggressive.
And this is why Puppy wanted to follow him in, because he wanted to prevent just this. Bulba needs to make sure he dodges the rolling boulder here.
Puppy is here, Iron Shell is up on the axe, and Yol will just, he'll sit around the creep stack.
Can he take a lot of damage?
He's gonna rolling boulder and get it in the process, and then get to the tier 2 tower, pull the creep wave. He might actually die here. Yep. And that's first blood for Bulba.
Oh, he did damage, so he gets the kill. Jeez.
That's not what he wanted. Yeah.
If he didn't put a stone down, he would have rolled through, got the last hit, and then been on the low ground and not rolled into the tower. But because he put the stone down, he went too far.
Meanwhile, Pasha is going to go down to the Thunder Strike top lane, and the rolling boulder from Yol. He's going to come in looking for Pilot Eye. He has the Orb of Venom, but Envy's here to help zone him out, and it's just going to be two quick kills going for Secret. That first blood gives Bulba so much more than I think the stacks were going to give him a lot, but Bulba's completely fine with getting
into the river with River Vile Slime.
Oh, yeah.
What is...
I'm
how
sure...
can you play Dota with this?
Arteezy's just trolling, and Dota people always do this just to troll.
Oh, God. I mean, it affects both teams, but if you've obviously played with it more, he's probably like been practicing his scrims with the slime river. That's like a new way of like taunting your opponent.
Goddamn, Neymar RTZ, honestly.
Have you seen this slime one though?
No, I've never seen this one. I've seen like electric blue. I've seen dry.
I like the electric blue.
Yeah, I do.
That
like
looks good.
One.
This one just looks.
It looks awful.
Awful. This looks incredibly awful.
The dry one I saw yesterday. I didn't know dry was a thing. It literally just looks like there's no river there.
Okay.
Like, okay, that's weird. But
Yep. The blood one's pretty cool too.
Yeah, I haven't seen that one. I think I might have seen it once, but I can't remember it off the top of my head. So right now, looking at the laning setup, Illidan, of course, is going to be getting free farm here for the most part. He's sitting at 24 last hits. He was behind in CS. Meanwhile, Kinetic Field, Pasha getting spun on. Should still be okay, as now he's under the tower and the TP's going to come through from the Oracle. Gets canceled, and so he won't need to have the Oracle out of lane bottom. Armin is probably okay here because he just can pull and get experience that way and maybe even gold. Sentries drop down inside the pull camp, or the hard camp, and that camp was not blocked. I think he was looking for maybe a ward here. I don't know why he dropped that sentry.
Yeah,
that's
you're blocking
very strange.
Camp? I'm morphling not a hero that rotates in the jungle that well, but...
I don't know what to say about that. I kind of want to draw a casual question mark on the ground. Pilot Eye, Silent Step, Rolling Boulder. They had the Boulder Smash to start things. They need Posh with the Void, but it's down for another 5 seconds. TP and Puppy, he's got Call, I hope. No, he's only just got the Battle Hungry. He's level 2. Another Void coming out, and Posh needs 2 more right clicks. Body blocks not there for Puppy in time, and Posh will run out with Boots of Speed at nighttime. Level 4 is now up, and on top of that, Rolling Boulder away from Yol, he should be able to get out in time. And it looks like they will secure a kill on the support without losing anything in the process. Nicely done from Fantastic Five getting the first kill on the board.
Yeah, Pai didn't need to turn around there, but he thought with Puppy's help he could get aggressive again, but...
I don't know if they can get this kill. This guy's level 2 tanky.
Tranquil Stout, he's fine, but...
Especially with Arteezy rotating up there.
I mean, for Fantastic Five, it's going to be very much playing like this full Protect 1 type strategy moving forward with the Morphling, where you're just kind of all in on Illidan going big in late game. Has Bulba. A salve, so he doesn't mind taking that. It's like not even really damage being taken.
So level 3 Iron Shell, that's just the jungle going to work already. And you can see he's gotten some decent farm there. They want to push down this tower, but there's another hero rotating in. It is Puppy, and if they go too far, Illidan might get caught by a Call, but still not there yet. He's only level 3. He actually is waiting for... No, he got 2 points of counter helix. I think he was waiting for... Oh, but here's the Iron Shell, and Illidan might have to strength morph even further. He's got 4 stick charges now, 5 surge forward. Fate's Edict will avoid some of that Iron Shell damage. Counter helix procs going through. He has the creep wave on him, and Illidan might get dove. He still has those agility traits. Will finally switch to strength and stay alive. Counter helix procs missing, and Puppy might actually go down. The tower hits. He's getting blocked by the creep waves, and there's no spins, and Illidan gets the kill. RNG is not there to favor you. Ice Frog says no.
When he turned to initially right-click Puppy, I was like, there's 3 creeps on him. I don't know if that's like a good idea when you're on... It was probably like 2 spins from death. If he got a bit unlucky there, Puppy kills him, but... I mean, he probably got really unlucky.
Yeah, Illidan looks like a genius now. Yol gets blocked by Arteezy. He'll find that kill. He won't find RMN. That's just a smart play from Arteezy. He's able to move in quickly enough to block the Rolling Boulder. That's the problem with the Earth Spirit sometimes. And Arteezy is sitting at 33 CS, 29 for BZZ, so it's not that bad. Yep. This is one there, but...
Tonight's slightly favoring the TA, but BZZ, obviously not really... Timbersaw not really for his denying capabilities.
No, I don't think so. Or his last hitting with his right click. One or the other. Yeah.
Has gone for 3 in reactive Omni. Normally you see like more like a 2-2-2 build, is what I've seen most Timbers do, but I think he wants to go a bit more defensive. You're against a TA where there's a lot of right clicks potentially coming in, you're taking more harass, so... Just being a bit more conservative with his approach.
Pasha has gone too far for this kill. Actually, Iron gelled up on Puppy instead. Vacuum, not available. He can TP now, I think, if he'd be okay. And then looks like he doesn't need to. Although the glimpse back, not there. Level 3, 2 points into Kinetic Field. Not the 1-1-1 we're used to seeing. But now mid lane, RTV rolling bouldered on. He still has the refraction up. Now it's down for 10 seconds. There's the Chakram coming through. He's got a side trap ready to go. He'll use it. BZZ's got Timber Chain, but it's only level 2. Chakram coming in. It's just not enough damage with Bulba nearby. They don't want to die for the kill. With 3 heroes around there, they might have been able to go for it, but they're just not going to be that aggressive.
That was just refraction for it. I was kind of clicking him, seeing like, oh, does he have double refraction? No, it was just needed the one and...
All right, last hits. There we go. No, that's not what I want. Where's the net worth? All right, we'll figure it out later. there it is, Q. Okay. Now, note, I'm not on my own account. That's why I had to do that.
Yeah, this was a bit of a last minute thing. we jumped in to cast this game for you guys, but... It's a big match. It's secret. You win it. You're going to TI. You're going to Seattle. So this is a good reason that... I mean, I don't want to say they're playing super conservative. It's more that their strategy by nature is looking to be greedier. And they know they can get away with the greed because of the Morphling.
That's just how Arteezy likes to play it. It's how Envy likes to play it. And if his supports can play around him, then even better. And you talked about sending Bulba to the jungle. You talked about Puppy in the jungle now. And then... Net worth-wise, they're doing pretty well. Two of the top 3, excuse me, going their way, including the Jug, who we haven't really talked about, but it is going to be Envy picking up a Void Stone, perhaps more than likely the Battle Fury later on down the road, which I'm fine.
Don't believe in the Yule's Juggernaut?
No, I'm not quite there yet, but maybe if Sumail does it somehow mid, I'll probably be a fan of it.
That's all it's going to take.
Yeah, I mean, I saw Shumail do terribly yesterday. I'm like, well, I guess that's a thing now. Yeah. I'm sure I'll see that in pubs.
Great stuff. That's the monkeys forever. That guy got like up to like 8 KMMR just playing Terrorblade mid, maxing Reflection.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know about 8 KMMR, but
that's not that shocking.
He like grinds that hero playing at mid.
Monkey's pretty good player. Yeah. So, for now, it's going to be able to continue to farm. They did take that tier 1 tower down bottom. I don't think they denied it. I'm pretty sure they got the last in on the tower, yeah.
So more got it. Slightly out-farming Jug in terms of net worth, but that's just the tower gold and the kill he got. So, not too big a deal. Jug was involved with and got an assist earlier, but I mean, realistically, Jug is pretty much on par with Morphling and will accelerate once you have Battle Fury. So the two carries doing as you'd expect them to do.
Yeah.
The two mids doing as you'd expect them to. They're kind of farming blow for blow. Nightstalker's a bit behind Darkseer, but he's kind of trying to be a bit more aggressive. And I think the key phase for Fantastic Five is the next night. Well, they're going to make it night now.
Yeah,
I was going to say 12 minutes in, but no, they'll accelerate that timing.
They'll just go for it. They're going to Timber Chain and looking for Bulba and Envy. Envy does have Omni Slash, and now it looks like Fantastic Five looking to back away. Arteezy's got a side trap in one. There's the False Promise. Good Omni, but doesn't do nearly enough damage. Posh just takes up all of that. The sounds comes through. Illidan's now in. The walls drop down. Doesn't get anything done. They'll lose the hero in the end of Fear and Spirit. Now BZZ in trouble. Walks through the wall. And they get off the Blade Fury kill. They're looking for the Void. Posh and Illidan walk through as well. The side trap is up. The waveform needs to go there so he can get the kill, and he will. And it will be a 2-for-2 exchange when it's all said and done. Maybe 3-for-2. They get off the feet. Zedek Arteezy's coming back in. This is so tough. The glimpse coming through. Waveform, not enough mana for it. On the other side, he still has his Ring of Health. Regening up. Here comes Yul back in. Boulder Smash. Refraction's still there. He's got plenty of charges.
He has mana for Waveform. There we go.
Puppy's looking. This could be a big call. Onto two. He gets silenced up in the end. Still, they're just going to work with the Iron Shell. They get the call off. The one dug, two dead. And eventually, it is Secret that takes the engagement. There's a TP coming in, but I don't think it's going to really do anything. Meanwhile, Arteezy finds another one on the backside as the Air Spirit got chased down. And so, Secret all of a sudden, because Arteezy just is able to survive and have his Refraction used well, he gets plenty of kills there.
Timbersaw missed a chain on mid to kill off the Darkseer, it looked like. He went aggressive and just slightly missed the mid tree, and everything kind of snowballed from there. The Darkseer staying alive to me is the really big one, because he stays on the edge and he's surging the axe in. He's putting an Iron Shell on the axe on the TA. He's giving these other heroes on his team more firepower and just the ability to re-engage.
So where does that put you for Fantastic Five? And where does that put you for Secret? I feel like that's a really bad fight for Fantastic
Five. Oh, yeah. It's pretty awful for them. I think even before that, they were slightly behind. This kill will help things out a bit. Illidan, yep, he gets it. But the big thing was, like, the cores were on par with each other, but Secret have the axe, who's getting more farm. So Secret have farm going the way of four heroes on the side of Fantastic Five. You're running, like, true two supports. Both Oracle and Earth Spirit are playing that, like, kind of selfless role. Earth Spirit roaming around playing pressure, Oracle being defensive, Axe is playing greedy. So even if the cores are on par, Secret, they're getting more farm because of the Axe. They also have more access to Roshan. They have more access to stack their Ancients, as we're seeing. TA right. Can farm that. So Secret are going to pull ahead using their farming tools, using the Rosh advantage, using a Jug Battle Fury.
Yeah, they're going to have that Battle Fury up pretty soon as Envy, I think he did die in that last engagement. Still, he has his Perseverance up. Arteezy now buys a Blink Dagger coming out, and he's going to have that for further aggression.
Yeah, good luck killing him now with the Refraction Blink.
Pretty much, you kind of have to get the Refraction down as he pops it up. Maybe get a Silence out from 9 Pasha or something, I don't know. But yeah, like you said, if he has that Refraction Meld, he can just Blink away, and you're fine pretty much. They'll look for Envy bottom. They don't have a silence here. They have to get up a 9 Pasha silence, and it's just not there in time. Forces in, the TP will come through, and there's no way they can stop it, and it's just not there. The Crippling Fear is actually a pretty small radius to actually be able to cast, so it's just smart from Envy to, as soon as they see anybody, just spin and TP away.
Yeah, good safe reactions from him, and Fantastic Five still, they're still going to scale well. That's a Morphling Timbersaw. There are, I'm trying to like think how good are they at dealing with a Timbersaw late game. And it's not bad for them. I'll catch y'all out here. But as far as bursting him down, the nice thing about TA is if you find the Timbersaw when he's got none of his reactive armor charges up, that first Melt Strike does so much damage that he's got no armor at that point. Timbersaw without the reactive armor is incredibly, well, not so much squishy, but he's incredibly low armor.
Yeah.
So at early stages and even the mid-game stage of the game, TA with Deso, Blink, Meld can quickly take away half of BZZ's HP.
Yeah, he's got 3 armor, and Infused Raindrop will not help you against Melt Strike from Arteezy. So although that is a great item, it is not good against the physical damage of a TA, nor the physical damage of a Juggernaut with Omni Slash. However, he still doesn't have that battle fury, but he's getting pretty close. Illidan is still above him in terms of net worth for the time being, and Illidan's item is going to be the almost certainly Linked Sphere. In fact, it is almost, yeah, definitely Linked Sphere. There's no way it's going to be anything else. Yep. Which is fine, it's just the standard Morphling pickup.
And the Glimpse being the one big spell that you want to block, and it's less... It's kind of like the same as Lincoln's on Medusa, where it's as much about the stats and the HP regen the item gives as it is about the spell block. In fact, it's more about the sustain you get from the item than the spell block.
Yeah, the mana regen, very good. Being able to waveform jungle camps all the time, a lot quicker with Aquila and Lincoln's Fear with Perseverance.
Because you're a hero that doesn't naturally jungle, you have to take damage to jungle.
There's that Meldstrike you were talking about with no reactive armor stacks, and he's just dead to the Static Storm. Yul's going to have to just hightail it out of there. 40 seconds. Glimpse comes through, Posh is gonna get put back. Arteezy though might be triple magnetize. That's a pretty good trade, as Illidan is the one that gets that. That is a dominating streak for Morphling. Almost 500 gold it looks like for the Morphling when it's all said and done, and that's gonna put him very close to his Lincoln's here.
Where the gold ends up and who the killer's on is just very influential there. Illidan, and you're running full protect one, you're happy trading your mid hero for the enemy mid when it's your carry, your one position carry getting the kill. So Morphling very happy with that. And he pulls ahead 1,000 net worth above TA, even more above Envy's Jug.
Yeah, that's huge. And Illidan is going to have to do some serious work this game, especially with the Timbersaw getting caught out a couple of times in a row. And maybe when he gets this Bloodstone, it'll be different. Envy is going to be close to Pasha. He's going to find him. Can they get the Silence off? Yes, the Void will come out. They need a Fortune's End. There's nobody else over here. They're going to get that Fortune's End off. They're going to bring him down with the Purifying Flames. Dead for 45, 314 gold. It's going to the Oracle, sadly. Still, they get the Tier 1 tower on top of this. They're going to push into the Tier 2, and guess what? Illidan has got enough money for his Lincoln's Sphere now, and all of a sudden, Fantastic Five have turned it around a fair bit. And they're still looking for more Armin, and looking for at least a... I thought he was going to drop down a ward, but he's just going behind the tower for no good reason, I think. And
getting aggressive. They know the jug down. Secret's in a bit of a rough position as far as defending a tower. The Omni Slash is one of their biggest tools to do so.
They should have Static Storm Puppy. Now with the blink, he's actually had it for a while. He's up to 900 gold. So
I like that aggressive move from Oracle, because you're in that position where it's like, we're not really going to... Our lineup doesn't push towers. Morphling right click is not there yet, so you're not going to get that Tier 2 tower. So going trying to scout behind the tower and find heroes for kills is a better approach, because you can kill heroes. You can dive towers, you just can't kill them.
Right.
But now Jug's back, they'll go back to farming to just kind of continue to stabilize this game.
So Jug and the Timbersaw kind of in the same position, and really Illidan is taking over pretty heavily in this game now. His Lincoln Spear should be flying out of the courier. I don't know what the hotkey is, I'll just click on it. There it is, and also an Urn of Shadows, which has been on the courier for a long time and finally has been picked up by Pasha. He's not really that farmed. In fact, you look at the axe and it's actually pretty close, but the Blink Dagger is going to give you a bit of an advantage for the Axe in this
regard.
The thing
is, the Axe is the full position as well, though, so it's like the Axe and Darkseer are kind of close to him and ahead of him, so still that scenario where Secret have four cores fighting into three, but it's not so much about the number of core heroes you have when there's a super fun Morphling. This is that kind of anti-mage type carry that can just put a game on his shoulders if
Darkness
he needs to.
Has been popped. They knew that Roche was happening. Chakram is going to try to push them out. They'll lose the Tier 1 tower bottom.
And they saw Secret stop for that Tier 1 top, the bottom tower. It looked like they were just trading. Morph was getting top Tier 1 while Secret took bottom, but once Secret didn't go for it, Fantastic Five were like, hold on a second, they're not pushing bot, they're going for Roche, let's stop this.
Secret is going to smoke up, and they're going to wrap and look for Illidan. He's the prime target, Yul as well. This could be a big blink call, but it's not there. He misses, waveform in time, adaptive strike, but there's going to be the... Oh man, they missed the Static Storm on everyone, the Magnetize coming through, and Yul gets false promise at the tail end of the engagement. Chakra Martizi melted up, will maybe go down, but he just barely gets the refraction off. Great call to stop any further damage, the Magnetize will bring him down. Misses the call, PZZ stays alive. They get the kill with more Purifying Flames. It's a 3-for-1 exchange, and Fantastic Five, what an engagement.
Yeah.
Wow.
It was so hard for Puppy to find the heroes for the blink call. He kind of had to blindly guess with that blink in, and the waveform meant that he didn't. Even if he catches Morphling there, they're unlikely to kill him because he's got Lincolns and he can morph strength, so it wasn't going to be a good call regardless, but Fantastic Five with a huge team fight to turn things in their favor.
And they can try to take Roche now. It's going to be difficult, and they might get in time. No Arteezy's for 12 seconds, no Darkseer for 13.
Jug's coming in, but he's got no Omni Slash. He can't really threaten this.
And he's going to get Rolling Boulder Dime. Vision across the
I love it.
The ravine from Yul.
delay.
The boulder smash, and there it is. I mean, it gives them enough time to get the Aegis on Illidan, and they can get out cleanly now.
Look how big the Molfing is now. 10k net worth, all of a sudden.
Glimpse back, Pasha gets out of the kinetic field. Waveform forward, Envy gets silenced up. Can they bring him down? Illidan, turn your attention to Envy. He gets up the healing ward. Spin will come through. Now the call is up. He's going to try to bring back Illidan. Yol is the big target that they want to bring down, as Illidan's pretty much impossible and has the Aegis. Kinetic field, they waveform through it. There's the Timber Chain, adaptive strike. They won't get the kill on Envy. They might get Puppy. They slow him for the side trap. There's going to be the Illidan using the replicate. He blinks away and they can't get it done. Illidan not having the mana to replicate it in time. It was actually just not there. And they don't get any kill. Although I think that's probably still fine. Fantastic Five.
They walk away the Aegis. Jug as well as Axe both very close to going down. It would have been a huge win for them to get the kills, but ultimately it's still fine for them. They're in the great position all of a sudden. Morphling. He's ridiculously big. He's going Ethereal.
He's got a Ghost Scepter all of a sudden.
I was about to say, Ethereal Blade not amazing against the cores of like Jug and TA. TA has Refraction, Jug can Blade Fury it, but it's still a great item just when you're playing from ahead. When you're playing from ahead as Morphling, being able to instantly take out a support or a hero like Axe and Darkseid, these heroes, they're relatively tanky, but a Morphling with an Ethereal Blade Lincoln's at like 22 minutes or so is going to still shred them.
Yeah, he's too far ahead now. I mean, even against the Axe, he'll probably be able to, with an Ethereal Blade and maybe one right click afterwards, I think he brings down those heroes, no problem, especially the Axe. And it is going to finally be the Bloodstone almost done. He needs the Vitality Booster. Same could be said for the Juggernaut. He finally has gotten his Battle Fury for Eternal Envy.
I'm not a big fan of Envy going for the Battle Fury. Yes, Secret's plan is to be greedy and play this four-core lineup where you're farming the Jungle Axe, you've got the Darkseer farming, you've got a very greedy four position, but I think you get away with that by having a build on Envy that can fight better. You go for your drums, your Manta, your Diffusal, and you can have these four cores, but you can actually fight when you have to.
They get the Refraction off, no Silence for Pasha, but they still do a lot of damage to RTZ in the process. Envy really wants to finish up the Ancient Stack, but two Black Dragons are not something you should, I guess, lose your life over. Although Arteezy's been caught in between a rock and a hard place, as there is a ward there. They're looking to jump on him. Unfortunately, they have to go all the way around the tower, and Arteezy, I think, knows this. In fact, he's got the Blink Dagger. I don't think he'll be able to get out, or rather, I don't think he'll be able to catch him because of the Refraction being up. It was a good effort, but it does push them back, and again, it just kind of chokes them out of the map. Secret want to be able to take Ancient Stack, so they want to be able to push across the river, but they really can't right now because of how far Dylan it is and the aggression from Fantastic Five.
And having an Aegis means they can play more aggressive. Taking these tier 2 towers sets you up to starve Secret out even more. Like you say, keep them away from the Ancient Stacks, and without tier 2 towers up, Secret lose a lot of map control.
Not to mention Darkness. If they even have wards down, they have no vision with the wards, and they don't even have any, I don't believe. They have one over here towards their own jungle, and that's it.
And when you get Ag's gem up on Night Soul, say goodbye to any vision.
And he's getting there. He's got the beginnings of an Aghanim Scepter too.
Oh, I like this play. They're going to re-engage off the smoke.
This is very smart. They're going to wrap and look for Arteezy, who's very far up.
Arteezy's the ideal hero to be in the front line, so to counter a smoke.
They know that he's there, too. He's going to walk up and try to CS. Instead, they're going to go to the back line look for Puppy.
They can't gank it easily. If you get the blink off, it's a wasted smoke.
Envy is going to go ahead and try to TP out. Call will be under 3. The Static Storm on top of it. This might be a good fight. Back wall onto all 5. Can they get the kills done here? They've already gotten the Oracle. Magnetizes up on Bulba. They might lose him. Still, though, a pretty good fight, all things considered, for Secret. It's a 1-for-2 exchange so far. Illidan might lose his Aegis, but he will almost get Puppy in the process. The Omni Slash comes through. It's on the Ghost Scepter and Illidan. Still a 1-for-nothing, or rather 1-for-3 exchange, and now BZZ is too far, and he went for that Timber Saw Chakram Willing Death. Now he's able to get up to the Timber Saw or Timber Chain up to the high ground. Glimpse back is there, and he will end up going down. He'll try the Timber Chain again, and finally Secret with a huge Static Storm from Pylai Dai into the Vacuum Wall. Bulba and Pylai Dai combining up to get the sickest fight, and they are not done. Illidan still with the Aegis getting called up. He's got Waveform. May very well have to use it. They should have a glimpse. They've already broken the Lincoln Sphere, but he's too far away at this point. And that'll be the end, but that is in a spectacular fight coming through.
That's the wombo combo. That's everything coming together perfectly for Secret. And you talk about having an Aegis being an advantage. Well, it's not an advantage if Secret can just ignore the Morphling and get everyone else in that combo. Morphling ends the fight still alive with an Aegis, so there is no Aegis advantage. And Secret land everything they need to.
Ooh, the raindrop keeps him alive. Illidan still with the Aegis. He's got a strength morph and keep himself up and ready to go. I liked what he went for there. Raindrop keeps them alive, though. Great item. One of the best items in the game. Yeah. Also, Timbersaw just got his Bloodstone during that fight, and he just immediately loses 4 charges.
That's not the ideal scenario for Timbersaw by any means. And not getting the suicide off Also, that's not exactly what you're hoping for to happen there. Envy's done a really good job of reacting with the Blade Fury. That was the one time at the Ancients he got caught out, but there's been now two or three scenarios where he's managed to just Blade Fury in time when he's about to get initiated on. And of the TA, as the two front lines for Secret, has really done wonders for them as far as playing a greedy lineup against an aggressive one, and they're getting away with it.
Yeah, Elden is going to have that Ethereal Blade soon, and he's, I think, going to need it now. I mean, he's done a good job of carrying this game so far, but he just doesn't do the damage yet. And with an Ethereal Blade, I think that all changes. That extra damage coming out. Yeah. Not only with, I think, his Ethereal Blade actual shotgun, but with the right click that he does is pretty important. Good try on that boulder smash onto Envy, but again, he played Fury at the right time, and he's looking to maybe go back in. Probably not. There's a lot of heroes here.
With the Ethereal Blade, heroes like Axe have to be very careful about how they initiate, because your Axe, you're looking at the Blink, the Force Staff, you haven't got survivability, you haven't got a BKB, you haven't got a pipe to negate that magic damage, so you've got to play very carefully as Puppy when you initiate. Similar story for the Darkseer. Darkseer, perhaps a bit tankier, has the mech as well. Also, when he has the Blink, he can just sit back and kind of counter-initiate, but these initiating heroes of Secret can get blown up right away at the start of a fight.
Yeah, I mean, Secret kind of have to be careful with their positioning. Fantastic Five waiting. Nighttime has just ended, so if they want to fight, they'll have to do it with Darkness, which is level 2. Pretty short cooldown now, at least a little bit shorter. 120 seconds. A lot of good vision from Fantastic Five, but Secret are starting to find their footing. Pretty good net worth now on both RTZ and Envy. They'll smoke up and they'll look for an engagement. And they smoked under this Observer Ward. So this
missing that ward.
Whew. Yeah, that's real unlucky. Now there's that Ethereal Blade. I wonder if you're Fantastic Five, if you look for an engagement on your own. They're just sitting right now behind their Tier 2 tower. There's somebody pushing into the Tier 1 that's RTZ. Although, here comes Secret behind there. Internal Envy's got that Omni Slash. Darkness is going to get popped. Bulba pops up the Iron Shell, still has Surge at the ready. The Tier 1 tower will go down, no deny coming out, and Secret will exit to the right. I don't know if they've been... Oh yes, they have the Replicate up. And Illidan just jumps in, he gets the Ethereal Blade off. Pile I Die gets dropped down by the Adaptive Strike.
They mech'd and Healing Warded for that too, so
fantastic. And he has a Raindrop.
Yeah.
I don't know what else you could do to keep your Disruptor alive, but that's pretty much it.
And that's how you've got to approach the fight as Fantastic Five. Have Morphling on the front lines, find an insta-kill. Disruptor's actually probably a... Disruptor acts the two big ones. Disruptor's the easier guaranteed kill. You see there, Mech and Healing Ward doesn't save him. So if you can kill the Disruptor, that Wombo combo of Secret is now just a vacuum wall. And the Static Storm won them that fight more than the vacuum wall did, because that's what prevented Oracle from getting spells off. The silence on the entire Fantastic Five team completely destroyed them.
So although there was a net worth advantage, it has swung back down into Secret's favor. I still don't think Fantastic Five are in that bad of a position, all things considered. So there's a 1,000 net worth advantage for Secret. They have the Blink Dagger up for Yol. We're getting to that point where it's getting kind of, let's maybe focus more on farm. Let's try to make sure we secure our late game potential. Although now with a new limited BKB for Arteezy and the Ethereal Blade, as we've talked about for Illidan, you have to wonder when the next engagement is going to break out, and I think it might be pretty soon as they have the Aghanims for the Night Stalker. Yeah.
This is where, like you say, I totally agree. Fantastic Five are not in a pretty good position. They're not worried at all. They've just hit the Ethereal Blade timing. The Axe is perhaps the just as big one that you want to have with the Ethereal Blade, because the vision advantage is it's going to be what takes away some of Secret's Roche taking potential. Secret, who drafted very much around this being a slower paced Roche game, you have to be scared of going for Roche when Nightstalker is Axe.
Oh, Pasha is going to get glimpsed back and that Axe is gone. They'll bring him down first. That's just the damage with Desolator. Not even using the BKB not needed for Arteezy. Just a smart play from Secret being aggressive. And it's right around again. This is the time we saw last game. It's right around the Roche respawn time. And they'll find it perfectly. And they're going to go right in, take it down. And the only thing you can really do for Fantastic Five is split push. But Illidan's not in the position to split push. He can't get up top. He has no Replicate sending himself up there with Armin. So it's just Yol up here. And this is not the best split pusher. In fact, I don't think he's going to even do any damage to this Tier 2 tower.
Yeah, it was a fairly fast, like a 45-second Roche respawn, which benefits Secret. If Nightstalker respawns before Roche is up, Fantastic Five can contest it, so Secret will be thinking they're lucky stars for that one, but they made that opportunity. They find the pickoff, there's a great smoke rotation, and then Roche happens to be up, and they know when Roche is up. They've got the TA scouting potential, so.
What do you think about the Ogre Cloak for Illidan? I hesitate to think that it's a BKB, although I'm...
I think it has to be BKB.
The only other thing I'm thinking of right now is Dragonlance.
Yeah, I don't think you go for a Dragonlance this late.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, it's a cost-effective good item on Morphling. It's all the stats you could kind of need, but if you want to go Dragonlance, I feel like you could get it much earlier.
Yeah, I agree.
I think it's just a BKB for the Disruptor Silent, and making sure he doesn't get caught in like a vacuum wall, too.
They have another smoke, are you kidding? Secret have. I feel like they've used all their smokes, but I keep getting
them. Think,
like,
did they use any in the early game? And no, they were farming.
That's true.
They've used them all in the last 5 minutes.
Did they give Pasha a gem? Okay, I just wanted to make sure they have a gem on him.
So, this is where smokes are really actually important for Secret, because against the Ags Nightstalker, you're not going to be able to move around the map without being detected at night.
Blink away, as Arteezy was about to get scouted.
Yeah, they see him.
They should see the rest of the team too. Oh, maybe not. They did. I think they saw him over here. They might have been smoked behind them actually. Unless the smoke dissipated, I don't think they actually used it.
Did they? Yeah, they may have not used it yet.
They still should have one in the. Yeah, they have one in the shop. I don't think they had one in the courier either.
Yeah. So they want to be. I mean, they could use it during this Aegis timing if Secret want to try and take a chance to get a big advantage. I like the hood pickup on Axe. You got to recognize that the biggest threat right now is the Morphling, and it's more magic damage than physical.
Right.
Once he gets. Like maybe four, like Lincoln's, he's going BKB, so once he has BKB plus like the butterfly or a manta, then he starts to right click a bit more, but for now it's the shotgun combo that's going to kill you off. I imagine someone like Pilot out Disruptor just wants to go straight into a Glimmer Cape, get a bit of magic immunity. Yeah, he's already got the casual cloak. Could even get a casual hood, like I actually think casual hood is really good for a Disruptor just to stay alive against Morphling.
Yeah, I would agree. And that's a Han player thing, as people have often told me, but I wouldn't mind seeing it for Pilot die in this game, just so that he can stay alive. I'm not even sure if that's going to be enough. Maybe with Raindrop enough against the shotgun.
Yeah.
Here we see Invade Juggle Fantastic Five with not all of their heroes, and Secret are looking to respond in kind. Envy is very far forward from the rest of his team. He still has Blade Fury. If they try to go for a shotgun on him, he could just spin it off. Timbersaw is kind of near the tree line over here. He's just away from the rest of his team, and now Illidan is... decided to hightail it out of there. His RMN as well as Yul are going to back away, and Secret just pushed down mid right now. They probably want to finish off at least one of these tier 2s, whether it's bottom, mid, or top, and I don't blame them for it.
It's definitely one of the limitations of the Fantastic Five draft is that they don't have that insta-disable. Like, there's a Blink Hex, like a Lion-type hero, that can... So if you're a TA or a Jug, you can make plays, like run around the map by yourself, and know that you're relatively safe. Until there's, like, a sheep stick on someone, and who's farming that, how are you actually going to die?
That's a very good point. BZZ is going to be the one that has to get it, and he's really not anywhere close.
And that's kind of like you're looking at like 45, 50 minutes down the line for Fantastic Five to win and kill these heroes. They're going to need cheaps, but right now it just allows Secret to play super aggressive with their kind of farming patterns and their rotation, so...
I think Puppy just went for a blind blink call. I think it was like here or something.
Okay.
And like, that's just exactly what you were talking about. Just being aggressive. Even Puppy, who doesn't have that spin or that reflection to work with. With Aegis still up, I don't see Fantastic Five looking to fight this, which is unfortunate because it means this Victory Tower is going to go down and Secret will accrue even more of an advantage. So they're just giving up little by little by little. That's a dire scan. That's a replicate they'll find. And they're looking for him. Blink call is going to go and... they'll waste probably a little bit on killing this replicate. It is taking a lot of damage to bring down. Boulder Smash comes through. The illusion is eventually killed, but nothing there that actually turns into an engagement for Fantastic Five.
Like, you look at this map right now, Fantastic Five have great map vision. They've got deep wards up. They've got the Nightstalker Axe Scepter. It's nighttime, but despite having a vision advantage, they can't get much done. The Jug and the TA are too unkillable. It's just the Morphling who's really farmed. The Timbersaw is in decent fighting shape, but... the problem is the Earth Spirit can't do enough in these fights because of Jug having Blade Fury, because of TA having BKB.
I mean, he pretty much needs to hit a Boulder Smash Silence for it to get a kill on either of these heroes.
And Oracle's that purely defensive hero as well, so it just feels like Fantastic Five is slightly missing having enough firepower to fight into Secret when they're grouped up. They can look for a pickoff here or there using the shotgun, but I almost don't feel like BKB is necessarily the best item here. I think Illidan may need to even consider something more aggressive, something... with a bit more damage output.
I think it might be too late.
But yeah, he's bought it. Until he gets another damage item, I think Fantastic Five just will lack the firepower.
Yeah. He's going to have to do a lot of heavy lifting. Because BZZ, I mean, he's 5,000 and 6,000 net worth behind the Jug and TA, respectively. Yeah. He's really just... and with Refraction, with Blade Fury, he's just not going to be able to pump out enough damage, with Mech especially as well. BZZ, I mean, he's going to have to kind of focus down the supports and try to bring them down quickly first. But it's... I don't know. I agree with you. I just don't think you fight without another right-click item for Illidan. I don't really see them contesting any more pushes from these squads. Envy does take, an adaptive strike from Illidan. The way forward, he wants to get that at least kill on the healing ward, which doesn't do much. He does push out the creep wave in the time.
Yep.
But Archie is still pushing bottom, and he's actually going to get the creep wave up to the tier 3 tower, and that's going to force a rotation.
And he's always going to be limited where he can't throw the shotgun at Jug or TA. So you've got a shotgun. The Axe now has a hood, so he's not a great target. Like, let's say the Darkseer or Disruptor, you shotgun one of those two heroes, and then how do you deal with the Jug and the TA? That's going to come from the right-click damage. So until he gets that one more item, he's not dealing with the Jug, the TA. His team sure aren't dealing with those heroes.
No. We might be waiting a while before we see our next big engagement. If we see an engagement, it'll probably be from this Disruptor smoke more than anything.
Yeah.
And actually, they're kind of grouping up now. Maybe I spoke too soon.
And Secret in the driver's seat, I think they can actually take the fight to Fantastic Five and on their own terms. It is such an important clutch game that they're more likely to play things conservatively. And the other concern is if you five-man too much, you're going to get split push. The Morphling is not good. I'm not going to look to fight into five heroes when he can just go to another lane and force you back.
Which is what he's been doing for a couple of minutes now. He did that in the top lane, just as you saw. They'll have to clear out that creep wave. And really, oh, alright, well, I thought I heard a static storm. For Yol, okay, 39 seconds. A kill is a kill. You're moving together as a team. You get some extra room on the map to work with, but he's only dead for 30 seconds. It's not the worst kill for Fantastic Five, but it's just, again, a kill after a kill that you really don't want to give up if you're Fantastic Five. I don't know what you get next as the Night Stalker. Well, I mean, maybe he gets the Hex or like an Abyssal, but that's going to take a long time to get to. Maybe you go Midas, just secure late game or something. Mm. Although it's a bit late.
Yeah, it's almost a bit late now, but Vlad's is a possibility, just to get the aura for your team. Don't mind. Yeah, there isn't really the ability for Oracle or Earth Spirit to find. And there's other items that Earth Spirit especially wants to go for over the Vlads. But and I think there's also some consideration where you try and, like you say, scale your Night Stalker to the late game, whether that's Midas or going straight into some kind of DPS, because right now it's looking like Morphling has to do this all on his own, and there's a lot of big, scary late game heroes.
Because I feel like Night Stalker late game actually is deceptively strong for a lot of people, or for a lot of heroes, against some of these heroes anyways. And you need some more damage coming out, and just any sort of disable, you know, because Void is not enough, as we've talked about time and time again already in this game.
Yeah. I think part of the problem is that the Crippling Fear, one of his biggest one of his biggest tools, the Silence, is going to get weaker and weaker as you go late game, because there's going to be Lotus Orbs, there's going to be BKBs.
Right.
Darkseer's going to have the Guardian Grief, so he can get rid of the Silence. Has he got it already? Oh, he's got it already, okay.
Yep.
5 minutes behind.
Not to mention the beginnings of BKB for him.
So, I mean, it's all about taking away the ability, like, as many of Fantastic Five's way to win fights, which is going to be, I mean, it's really all magic damage until Morphling gets, even when Morphling gets the right-click item, like, let's say this is a six-sided Morphling, if everyone on Secret can block all the damage output, the physical damage isn't enough from Illidan, no matter how many items he has. So,
because he can only target one person with his right click.
Yeah. And so having right click items is not the only solution for like getting Illidan more farmed. Is not just like the way to victory for Fantastic Five. They have to find answers with the rest of their heroes. Maybe it's like an Ag Scepter on Yol's Earth Spirit to make some big flashy plays to catch some heroes out or to make saves. But BZZ needs a ton of. We need to see that scary late game Timbersaw with Shivers, Ag Scepter, Hex, Octarine, whatever it may be. But the farm is just not really there for BZZ. The catch from Secret is kind of preventing him from moving out on the map.
It feels a lot like last game where Arteezy and Envy and everyone else, they had like four late game cores or even five late game cores if you were able to get to that point, and it was just inevitable that they were going to win that game. It kind of feels the same way here. I do feel a bit better about Illidan and his farm, but he has now been equipped by Arteezy on that TA, so that's another big sign.
It's just, yeah, a sign of things to come when, I mean, four of the top six heroes on the Secret side, Darkseer and Axis starting to pull even further away from that Night Stalker. And that's where it's like, you talk about a Night Stalker trying to scale more to the late game, getting some maybe more DPS items or fighting items, but if you're this far behind, like, there's no fighting items that really allow you to fight. If you're 10k, or even just 5k net worth behind like the enemy offlaners and stuff, and 10k net worth behind the enemy carries, you're not fighting it. You're not going to trade right clicks with a TA or a Jug.
Right.
That's a losing battle. So, yep. I think Night Stalker's almost just has to just go for a Vlad's or something cheap, cost effective. Similar story with Oracle and Aerospirit. They're just going to have to go for utility items. Yeah. Medallion, that's a nice option.
Good call as he picks that up and it flies it out to him. Gets that medallion ready to go.
You just got to recognize that. I mean, these heroes don't want to build MK. It forces them into an MKB, maybe a direction they don't want to go. Jug would rather get like a Butterfly or a Moonshard TA. Has the Daedalus, but it will take some time to get an MKB up, and then it limits their late game itemization, having to be forced into an MKB. Or if they don't go MKB, then you've got the evasion on your frontliner.
Oh my god, this is such a good play. And Fantastic Five, if they commit to a fight now, I'm sure they will lose a tier 3 tower at the very least. And be still sitting top lane right now and working on that set of racks, I'm sure. And in fact, you probably need to leave
this
and
keep
home.
This is so brutal, yeah.
This is just a smart play. And we might get caught. Yeah, they have no catch.
You can blade through your TP and that's almost Roche secured. Although they have left everyone else here apart from Timbersaw. Question is, how fast is... I like that Envy's not TP'd yet because he's recognizing, like, okay, they only TP'd Timbersaw. They're trying to make a play where Timbersaw gets back for that Roche fight. But the answer may just be sending the Morph Replicate up top or something. And if you can get the Morph Replicate top, then he can perhaps use that to push it out.
He has it. He's not yet.
I think it just expired, yeah.
Oh, okay. Courier's... Ooh, that courier almost got scouted. It is the Shivas for BZZ. It could have been a Hex. I'm fine with Shivas too, but again, it's just... we keep harping on this lockdown issue, but it's going to continue to be an issue until they get some sort of item.
There's like so many items he needs. The Shivas is by no means a bad choice. It's just a different approach to the game.
Ooh, are they going to find Envy? Boulder Smash comes through. Waveform Adaptive Strike pops the BKB. Can he TP out in time? Timberchain is up. BKB, Shivas Guard coming through. They need more right click. Do they have the job? They do. And he is down for 83. He does have buyback. That is probably the most important kill so far in this game for Fantastic Five. But it looks like they will have to trade Roche for it. And that's almost not worth it.
Just kind of goes back to the Blink Dagger pickup on Earth Screen. It was just a great item selection because it gives him that Blink, like, melee stun opportunity onto the Envy Jug. And that was where the damage... It allowed them to get the shotgun damage without him Blade Fury dodging. And then he can't blade through your TP because he'll die to the physical.
They'll find Pylite die at the very least with the Boulder Smash. The Void comes through. They had to wait for the Kinetic Heal to go down. Fortune's dead. Everyone's already TP'd back, so Pylite Eye is left to his own devices. He did buy before dying, so at least that's going well for him. So two kills, one being a Jug, and that's not a very important kill. It actually gives the Morphling more net worth than RTZ and gets him up to close to that, I would imagine, Manta style. What were you looking for?
I was just seeing who killed the Jug. I was wondering if Timbersaw got the kill. I think Timbersaw getting farm right now is the big thing, but Earthstrike got the last hit. Not the best, but hey, it's still like a 800 gold swing his way.
Eventually gets that Aghanim Scepter, maybe, yeah. You look back at that kill, I'm like, okay, maybe that's huge. Blink Dagger for Nightstalker, actually.
Okay.
That's one way to get close.
Blink Silence, yeah. But Envy has the Manta style, so he has a way out of it.
What is RTZ building next? I think he got the... Oh, he got a Daedalus. Plus yeah. 3.1k. Man, he hits hard. Luckily, there are a couple of Ethereal Blades. One for Timber. There's, I think, one for the... Yeah, Oracle 2. Obviously, Ethereal Blade gives you the Ghost Form as well, if you use it on yourself. I think was the change that was made a while ago. And
he'll probably just save money now to see if he needs an MKB. If you see Morphling going Butterfly, or even just the Solar Crest may result in an MKB purchase.
I think Illidan goes for Butterfly eventually.
Yeah, it's like one of those ideal items to have on a Morph, but you want to try and... If you can buy it and RTZ is committed to something other than MKB, the item's even better, so... There is some reason to try and hide the item pickup, but... For now, yeah, Illidan, he's scary. He's getting there.
But it's another 5 minutes where they have to deal with Aegis, though.
Yeah. And the Manta's the split push, where you're recognizing the state of this game, where we're always going to be lacking ways to team fight and actually kill off the Jug to TA. We can get pickoffs, like you, and try and punish the Jug like we saw top, but realistically, Secret with Aegis, if they're five manning, you stop Secret's push, not by fighting into them, but by split pushing the side lane. So Morphling, I think his next item is actually going to be a Boots of Travel, if anything, just to give him that global movement before he goes for anything, like before he commits to his six item.
I'm down for that. BZZ just purchased his, so both of them getting it means that the split push is definitely an option. Tier 2 tower top's already gone, so Illidan will push in and try to force out TPs towards that tier 3 tower. Micro your illusions. Micro your illusions. Okay. It took you a bit longer than I anticipated.
He could be attacking as we speak. That's game losing, Mott.
He missed out on some damage, man. That's just not efficient. You hate to see it. Yo. He tries to clear out the creep wave, but here comes the rest of secrets.
Halfway to an axe. Other nice thing about the axe is to block the Omni Slash damage.
Yes. Some defensive capabilities here for sure from not just him, but the rest of his team as well.
Yeah. Secret have got themselves in position where the split push at top is still outside of their base, so they may feel confident to try and
reach the high
ground.
He got his Manta back up. He could just go in Manta and maybe even have himself. He's got a BKB. I don't see...
No, creeps in the base. Glyph on the Radiant side,
this
though.
Is bad. I think they just lose their melee racks, I'm pretty sure. Although the Shiva's Guard will go. They get the Boulder Smash off. Arteezy does have the Aegis. Magnetize will go. The Void's up next. Praxis still there. He's got it. Still not using it. Meanwhile, now the TPs will go. Range Brax taken down by Illidan. And here comes Puffy. Misses the call, though. Adaptive Strike. He's got the Ethereal Blade, but he gets the Force out. Eats the cheese. Waveform comes through. Illidan still wants this kill. Meanwhile, everyone is getting chased down. They did take down the Aegis, mind you. And Arteezy gets Boulder Smashed and silenced up. The Force Sim has to pop the BKB. They are missing that right click, though, from Illidan. He actually got the melee racks, but now it looks like everyone is dying for Fantastic Five. It's secret. They just get Arteezy to pop his BKB. BZZ will go down momentarily. He's caught by the kinetic field. Timber chain out, but now Arteezy's here with some surge, and that's a triple kill for him.
Very close to bring down Envy there. I think it was really well played by Fantastic Five. They get the top racks. They've now got buybacks as well. And they're actually going to defend their racks.
Yeah, they take a full set top lane.
As great as it was, I think it could have been even better if they didn't overcommit to the chase. They need to just stop the TPs. Like, Nightstalker has the vision. If he just chases with a Blink Dagger, he can Blink Void to stop TPs back. And Morphling in the end, I think he could have even threatened to get at least the tier 3 tower mid.
Illidan? Okay, yeah, they did not want to fight him. I thought they were going to go on him for a
second. It was just Puppy defending, and we saw what he was doing to Puppy. He was wrecking him, so I think he could have even considered threatening the mid-tier 3 tower and the mid-racks there, but he plays it safe. So you get the one lane, you get back off, your team defended your own rack, so it's still a big win for Fantastic Five. I kind of look back and think it could have been even better.
Yeah, they did have to buy back on BZZ, and now he's gotten down to 7 Bloodstone charges on top of Nightstalker going down, but he did not have to buy back. And Oracle had to buy back, I think. Yes, he did. Although he has 1,200 gold after buyback, which is pretty impressive.
Envy and the Secret team just going to be having nightmares about, like, no TP's back to base,
yeah,
you know?
I mean,
it's the classic Eternal Envy play.
I don't know how that happens against Envy again.
Yeah.
That's just...
We'll see the fight again in a couple minutes and see if, like, there was some TP cancel or anything. But I only saw the Axe's TP being channeled to defend, and Axe cannot fight the Morphling by himself.
Yeah, I saw Illidan go up there. I was watching that fight for a while, and then I saw them try to back up, and then I saw Arteezy just die, and I was like, what? Okay, well, that's interesting. Still, Secret not in that bad of a position. Sure, they lost a set of racks, but again, forcing out 2 buybacks, winning a pretty big fight. Arteezy is so tough to deal with when he pops that BKB. If Illidan's there, they probably, because he was at maybe 25% HP, they'd probably kill Arteezy in that situation if Illidan's there.
Yes, and he didn't have the boot to travel. That could have been like the difference maker as far, he still doesn't as far as getting right back into that
Scotty
fight.
Next, I think.
Well, Scotty's actually a good option.
Scotty or Butterfly, one of the two.
Yeah. The Butterfly can get, the evasion component can get countered more, but what's the AK? There
it's Orb of Venom,
as soon as you mentioned Sky, I'm like, that actually sounds better.
Oh,
than
the courier's been scouted, and V sees it. Oh, okay, that he bought everything.
Oh, I was about to say, if
he bought everything on that courier.
Nine, it's not necessarily a game losing, it just delayed. It's more like it just pretend he didn't have the farm for Scotty yet.
Right, alright.
But, yeah, he's still in a good position.
It's 2 minutes and 40 seconds. It's not that bad. It's like waiting out an Aegis or something.
I think the bigger issue is he doesn't have buyback, I believe.
He shouldn't now, no. Yeah, he's 330 gold away, though.
He can farm
that very quickly, especially with his illusions. Yeah. But here's the push coming in top. They want to even up this rack situation. They're going to smoke behind Bulba.
If he dies without buyback, he's going to have nightmares tonight.
Yeah, I mean, as bad as it was for Envy to lose that set of racks, it's going to be even worse if Illidan goes down in this fight. Although he is very strong, even without Scotty. Puppy jumps in, gets the call onto PZZ. He bought back, and he's the one that dies without buyback. And now, this is looking bad. BKBs were popped, though, not for Arteezy necessarily. Lincoln Spear was broken, as I think they were looking for a glimpse or something to just try to break it. Waveform through, they get the... Nildan's gonna pop the BKB in man fight. I don't know if this is gonna work. Bulba's gonna get caught, magnetized, Static Storm on top, misses on everyone. They will bring down Yol nonetheless, and Illidan, this man fight is not working. The False Promise Envy does some serious damage, and he even goes down after the false promise.
Oh,
Fantastic
no.
Five might have just ended the game for themselves. Secret putting themselves in a great position now, and it looks like they will move on to the TI main event, and well done from this squad. They made a couple of mistakes here at the end of the game, but when it came to crunch time, they were able to get the job done, it looks like.
That was just such a brutal way to lose the game. Losing your Scotty, and then he must... How far away from buyback is he? He got it to like 1,700 gold.
He was 300 at one point. It's 200 now.
Oh, that is just...
Once they killed that courier, they knew that he probably had bought something there.
I mean, this game was still a very even game. Even with the racked advantage, it still felt like momentum was... Like, Secret were more the ones in control, but... To lose in that fashion as Fantastic Five is just brutal.
I can't believe that happened. Envy's like, okay, we killed the courier. There's probably a morphling item on the courier at this point in time. And with that, we probably try to force in. They find themselves to kill on BZZ. And Illidan kind of has to do it all on his own. They get off the stone form with the Enchant Remnant pushing back. He gets forced forward, pops the BKB. He might still die to the well and will, but... they'll barely defend, and I can't even really call it defending at this point. They've lost Megas, and Pilot Eye might go down, but that's really only a small consolation prize. He might even get out, honestly. No, he's dead. Okay.
I mean, I guess we can't quite call this game just yet with a six-slotted Morphling and a potential just to go for the throne if you're in Fantastic Five position and can win one fight. But it is going to be...
One of the greatest comebacks in Dota history. Maybe the greatest comeback, I think, because of how far behind they are now. That's a full three sets of racks, 25,000 net worth advantage. Illidan now has gotten the courier respawn. He'll buy another point booster, or rather the point booster I think that he needed to get for the... And it wasn't just him, I don't believe. It was a Talisman of Evasion for Arm, and it was actually his Silver Crest too, so that would have made it even harder to bring down Illidan.
Because I didn't see the Scotty pop-up, so I was like, well, okay, so it didn't have... For a second, I didn't think it had the Scotty, and he still had the money, so...
Courier? No, Pasha, you won't be able to, you won't be as lucky as Envy. And that's too dead.
Yeah.
And probably the entire team now. As Illidan's gonna have to pop the BKB, the Omni Slash will go. Good Ghost Scepter's coming out, but probably too much at this point. Waveform away, BZZ too far, and they get the call. Good false promise, but he is not doing nearly enough damage, and that is it. The Culling Blade and Static Storm for Victory Parade, and Team Secret will move on to the TI main event, and really, was there any doubt this team was star-studded and made it through the open qualifiers with relative ease?
There were some doubts.
Yeah, all right.
Open qualifiers, thrown on 1,000 HP. I think Secret fans had a lot of doubts, but...
Pro Dota, best team, EU, perhaps, or what the other team they were really down against as well. But
they had some close shaves in the open qualifiers. Needless to say, they were still the second one, but regionals, they delivered. They had some close games, but they definitely looked like the best team in regionals, so I think they are well deserving of that spot at TI.